فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
Now we're going to go into أنواع الإعراب. Now we're going to go into what? أنواع الإعراب, the types of إعراب. قال, he said, وأقسامه أربعة. The types of إعراب there are is four. رفع ونصب وخفض وجزم. فللأسماء من ذلك الرفع والنصب والخفض ولا جزم فيها, وللأفعال من ذلك الرفع والنصب والجزم ولا خفض فيها. So we have أنواع الإعراب. We're now going to go into the types of إعراب. The author mentioned how many? He mentions four types. He said, وَأَقْسَامُهُ. The types of إعراب there are four. The first one is رَفْعٌ. What does the word رَفْعٌ mean? What does it actually mean في اللغة, in the language? All of اسم محمد محيدين عبد الحميد. He's writing the sharah. What does it mean in the language, the word رَفْعُ? It means العلو والارتفاع. It's when it's high and it's above. That's what it means. The word رَفْع, it means when something's high. Good. And اصطلاح is what? Technically, what does the word رفع mean technically? It means تغير مخصوص علامته الضمة وما نبع عنها. It is a specific form of changing where the sign becomes a ضمّة and anything that takes its place. What are the things that take its place? We're going to see them soon, inshallah ta'ala. Are you there? Alif, waw, and noon. We're going to see them, inshallah. So we're going to know, as he said, وستعرف قريبا ما ينوب عن الضمة. What are the things that take the place of the ضمة? We're going to come to know that soon, inshallah ta'ala. بإذن الله الكريم. Such as the word يقوم علي ويصدح البلبل. If you look at the last ending of the word يقوم م, this word م is رفع. علي is رفع. يصدح ح is مرفوع. البلبل is مرفوع. That's what it means لغة. And that's what it means اصطلاحا. Very good. Then the author says, the author of the kitab, Al-Ijrumiyya, he says, وَنَصْبٌ. Second علامة, the second type is what? It's نصب. What does نصب mean? What does نصب mean? فَهُوَ فِي اللُّغَةِ الْإِسْتِوَاءِ وَالْإِسْتِقَامَةِ. In the language, what does it mean? استواء. When something is what? Upright. When it's upright and it's steady. Are you with me? الصلاح, what do you say? تغير مخصوص علامته الفتحة وما ناب عنها. It is a specific changing where its sign is a fatha and anything that takes its place. And we're going to see the things that are going to take its place soon, inshallah ta'ala. For instance, لن أحب الكسل. أحب الكسل. أحب. It's got a nasb, which is a fatha. الكسل. It's got a fatha as well. That's what it means. Then the third one is وَخَفْضٌ. الخفض. What does خفض mean in the language? فَهُوَ فِي اللُّغَةِ تَسَفُّلُ. تَسَفُّل means when something goes down. So the word خفض is the opposite to the word رفع. Are you there? It's خفض when something goes down. Are you there? And اصطلاحاً is تَغَيُّرٌ مَخْصُوصٌ عَلَامَتُهُ الْكَسْرَةُ وَمَا نَابَ عَنْهَا. Is a specific form of changing where kasra is its sign and anything that takes its place. We're going to learn what takes the place of kasra, inshallah ta'ala. And we're going to see nahu ta'allamtu min al-kasuli. Kasuli is what? Got kasra there. And this sign, which is kasra, sorry, this sign, which is khafd, is specific to what? Specific to the noun. It's specific to the noun. وَأَمَّا الْجَزْمُ We got now jazmi. We got jazm. فَهُوَ فِي اللُّغَةِ الْقَطْعُ Jazmu means what? When you cut something. When you cut that decision, this matter has been decided now. Are you there? The word jazm is used. When the person gives a unwavering conviction now. Jazm, he's come with that jazm. One of the conditions of Tawbah is that you come with that decision. You cut that decision. Istilahan, what does it mean? It means تغير مخصوص علامته السكون وما ناب عنه. It is a specific form of changing, and its sign is a sukoon and anything that takes its place. ولا يكون الجزم إلا في الفعل المضارع. And jazm only enters the what? أي فعل مضارع. Such as لم يفز متكاسل. متكاسل. لم يفز. We're looking at the word. لم يفز. يفز. What is the word here that we're looking at is? We're looking at the word yafuz. The word yafuz. Look at the ending of the word. Z. Za has a sukun on it. This is the alamat and the aqsam of i'rab. The author then says of the kitab al-ajrumiyya, فَلِلْ أَسْمَاءِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ الرَّفْعُ وَالنَّصْبُ وَالْخَفْضُ وَلَا جَزْمَ فِيهَا وَلِلْ أَفْعَالِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ الرَّفْعُ وَالنَّصْبُ وَالْجَزْمُ وَلَا خَفْضَ فِيهَا. So now let me do the summary of the anwa' al-i'rab, inshallah. Does anyone have a tissue? No, tissue. Bad, yeah. Okay. We're now going to take anwa'u, the anwa'u al-i'rab. Jazakallah khairan. جزاكم الله خيرا. يا. This it worked, Abba. It worked. الله أكبر. Okay. Jazakallah khair. A date الذي عليك. You don't want yours upon you. Okay, Abba, go. Take your jundi with you, a soldier. Okay, the anwa' al-i'rab, the types of i'rab there are. The first one is مشترك بين الأسماء والأفعال. So the first one is mushtarak. Okay. مشترك بين الأسماء والأفعال. The first type is shared between the أفعال and the what do you call it? Some type is shared between the ism and the, and this is two, right? الرفع and النصب. رفع and نصب are علامات which are shared between the noun and the verb. Both of them have رفع. Both of them have what? Both of them have. Then we have the type we call مختص. مختص means it's specific to either the noun or specific to the verb. So if we start with bil asma, what's specific to the asma? Al khafdu. And then we have the bil afal. And what's specific to it? Al jazmu. So you will never find a noun that has jazm in it. You will never find a verb that has khafd in it. Yes, khafd. Does that make sense? That's what he means by the author. وَجَزْمٌ فالاسم من ذلك الرفع والنصب والخفض ولا جزم فيه فيها وللأفعال من ذلك الرفع والنصب والجزم ولا خفض فيها. And the شارح الشيخ محمد محي الدين عبد الحميد actually explains that he says فقد تبين لك أن أنواع الإعراب على ثلاثة أقسام. You see, قسم مشترك بين الأسماء والأفعال وهو الرفع والنصب, وقسم مختص بالأسماء وهو الخفض, وقسم مختص بالأفعال وهو الجزم. And I wrote the diagram for you on the board. Now we're going to go into باب معرفة علامات الإعرابي, knowing the signs of إعراب. Okay, we're now going to go into باب, the chapter of knowing معرفة علامات الإعرابي, knowing the علامات of إعراب. Each علامة of إعراب that we take, inshallah ta'ala, there's going to be an علامة which is أصلية and an علامة which is فرعية. Are you with me? Each one. The رفع is going to have that, the نصب is going to have that, the خفض is going to have that, and the جزم is going to have that. An علامة which is أصلية, an علامة which is فرعية. An علامة which is فرعية. So let's start inshallah ta'ala with this point before we go in. Brothers and sisters, okay? This is where it really is the reality of nahw, grammar. Here it starts, okay? Back in the days, the students used to not watch their teacher. They used to say, "Ustad, I'll do it for you. Ustad, just relax, you know." Qadr Allah, life has changed, you know? A lot has changed. And they still don't get up after them being told that. It's just qadr. You're differently. Okay. Okay, good. So now, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to talk about something. This is the important part. باب معرفة علامات الإعراب. If you understand this point, brothers and sisters, and you've not really understood a lot about the previous classes, you could work on yourself. This is the gist. This is the asal. This is where it bottles down to.
What did we say? What did we take when we spoke about kalima? Al kalima. What did we do? We categorized it into what? Three. We said it is what? The first one was what? Ism. And then we said it's what? Fi'lun. And then we said it's a what? Harfun. Right? Did we not do that? We said the kalima in the Arabic language is categorized into those three. And then we said the ism is three types. We said ism which is dahir, apparent. Let's go on one siyaq and one form. Ism which is mudhar. And then we have ism which is mudmar. And we have ism which is mubham. Fi'l, we said it's three types. Fi'l which is al-madi, al-mudari', and al-amr. Sah? And the harf which we said, mushtarak. Sah? We said mushtarak bayna al-asma'i wal-af'al, shared between the verb and the noun. The same last mukhtasun bil-asma' and then we had mukhtas bil-af'al, right? Do you guys remember that? So we had the ism which is mudhar, apparent. Then we had the mudmar. The mudmar are three types. Remember, the mudmar, the mudhar, the mudmar is three types. Does that make sense? Okay, let's just cut that out. Okay, let's divide it into three. Or divide it into two. Dhamair which are munfasil, and then those which are muttasil. Or we can say those which are mustatir. Let's just leave it with those two. We don't need to know more about that. That's not what concerns us right now, okay? Each one you can bring out so much categories out of it. But the point is that the noun is mudhar, mudmar, mubham. What's mudhar? Every apparent noun, okay? In English they call it proper noun. Mudmar is pronouns. And mubham are like, in Arabic language, mubham are ismu ishara, asma ishara, asma which are mawsoola. They're what? They're mubham. Mubham means that it's a noun, but it's not owned by a particular person. If you say huwa, he, it can be any brother in this room. So I'm standing there, I'm talking to a brother, and I go, he said that to me. He's going to be like, okay, that word, he, is ambiguous. It can be anyone in front of you. Sahih? Does that make sense? That's why it's called mubham. It's unclear. Who are you referring to? The person will still say to you. But if I say, Sa'ad said it, everyone, he's going to look straight at Sa'ad because this is an apparent name. It's going to hit one person in the room. Does that make sense? If I say, Al-Ladhi, the one, Al-Ladhi, that's Ism Ishara, right? Ism Mawsool. Are you with me? Al-Ladhi, the one. The person's going to look at you and say, okay, Al-Ladhi can be any the one. Does that make sense? So that's what Mubham means. We said that when we're talking about Nahu, I'rab, and we're studying grammar, we don't talk about in the chapters of I'rab Mudmar. We don't grammatically analyze Dhamair pronouns. Nor do we grammatically analyze Mubham. We don't analyze them. Ism Ishara, you're not going to do I'rab of it. Asma Mawsoola, you don't do I'rab of it. Does that make sense? So the only thing that came to us from here. So let's just take the word mudmar here and put it here for us. So you have mudmar. Mudhar, sorry. Does that make sense? Very good. That's one. Keep that for us over here. Go back here. Fi'il. What did we say? Fi'il are three types. Madi. We don't grammatically analyze it. Get rid of it. Mudari'. Yes. Mudari', we grammatically analyze it. Why don't we do the grammatical analyzation of the word madi? Because it's mubham. Sorry, it's because it's mabni. Because it's what? It's mabni, it's not mu'rab. So it doesn't come into i'rab. So, okay, good. So do you take the mudari'? Yes, we do take it. Put it here for me. So we say al-mudari'. The mudari'. What about the amr? Yeah, amr, we don't grammatically analyze it because it's mabni. Get rid of it. So we only took from here what? The mudari', jameel. What about huruf? All of them, we don't do grammatical analyzation of it. Not any of them. So we are only left with what? Babu ma'arif, ma'arifati alamat i'rab. We've only got these two. Good. Are we all together? Am I making sense or am I not making no sense to you guys? Are you guys with me, brothers and sisters? Yeah? Very good. This is the part, this is the point that you have to understand. Okay. Write the mudmar here for me. Mudhar here for me. So, number one, what am I doing? I took the mudhar. Are you with me, brothers? Mudhar gave six things come under mudhar. Are you with me? What is it? Number one, ism mufrad. Number two, muthanna. Number three types of jama'. Jam'u, mudhakar. Jam'u, mu'annath. As-salim. Jam'u, at-taksir. And then we have last but not least, asma'u. Those are all from what? They all come from ism mudhar. A singular noun. Ay muthanna, dual. Jam'u dhakar salim, mask. Each one we're going to take it. Are you with me? These six, they come out from mudhar. Good. Take mudari' for us. Okay, the mudari' is number two. The al-mudari' is what? It's two things. Two come out of it. The first one is al-fi'lu. Al-fi'lu al-mudari'. Hey, what is it, Imran? Al-fi'lu al-mudari' al-ladhi? Al-ladhi lam yattasil bi-akhirih shay. Bi-akhirih. And the next one is amthilatu khamsa. What they call af'alu khamsa. Does that make sense? That's it. That's grammar. These eight are what's going to follow us في حالة الرفع والنصب والجر والجزم. We're dealing with these eight. Does that make sense? These eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So what we're going to first need to, before we go into the halatul raf'i, halatul nasbi, halatul jarri, halatul jazmi, before we enter it, we need to know what's ism mufrad. What is dawabid? How can I identify what's ism mufrad? Muthanna, how can I identify what's a muthanna? Jam'u mudhakkar salim, how can I identify what's a muthanna? Are you with it? Jam'u mudhakkar salim, jam'u mu'annath salim, jam'u taksir. Are you with me? Asma'ul khamsa. How can I... Each one we're going to discuss properly. Are you with me? Does that make sense? So we first of all have to know each one before we study alamatul raf'i, alamatul nasbi, alamatul jazmi, before we go into it. Does that make sense? Because these are the eight that's going to follow us. Now, let me just mention one thing and then I conclude there. What did I just mention before when I was talking about anwa'ul i'rab? What did I mention when I was talking about anwa'ul i'rab? I categorized anwa'ul i'rab into two, right? Mushtarakun bayna al-asma'i wal-af'al. What was mushtarakun bayna al-asma'i wal-af'al? Al-raf'u. So Jameel, these eight are only going to fully occur in two situations. Because mudari' is a fi'il and the mudhar is a ism, right? So it's only going to occur together in two situations faqat. Fi halatayni faqat. Two situations. What halatu what? حالة الرفع and حالة النصب. They all come because these are the two times when they're mushtarak. Are you with me? لكن when you go to حالة الجزم, you're only going to be dealing with these two. When you go to حالة الخفض أو الجري, whichever you call it, you're dealing with only these six. Because jar is khas to who? Who's it mukhtasun bih? The jar, I mean the khafd, it's the same, yeah. Jar and khafd are both the same. Khafd is specific to what? Asma', right? So this is asma', only these six can, you don't talk about, when you're talking about khafd, you don't talk about this. You don't talk about that, you talk about this. When you come to the situation of al-jazm, you only talk about these two and you don't talk about? Do you get my point? That's it. You just have to memorize these eight in these four ta'alamat that you've mentioned to me, naf al-raf'u, wal-nasbu, wal-khafdu, wal-jazmu. How do I deal with these eight in these situations? That's all it is. That's what Babu Ma'arifat alamat al-i'rab is. Once you learn that art and you get the ability, you'll be, mashallah, fluent in making harakat and tashkil of books, reading it yourself, inshallah ta'ala. And we'll take it very detailed, bi'ithnillah al-kareem, with many examples, inshallah ta'ala. Many, many examples to take on board. Inshallah ta'ala, as for today, we'll conclude there, bi'ithnillah al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.